In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and God, Amen. Actually, I'm very happy to see all of you gathered here in Orlando in the first One Cup convention. And as I said before, I think you heard my word yesterday. The idea of One Cup actually is very old. We started thinking about it maybe 7 or 8 years ago, and we're thinking to do a convention, international one, and we were thinking at the time at Hawaii. So it will be, it is in the middle between Australia and North America. And then actually, Bishop Thomas in Egypt said, no, let's do it in Egypt. And actually, it was planned for, I think, in 2011, which was 1 month before the revolution, and when Egypt started to have a lot of trouble. So this convention was canceled. It was announced, maybe some of you get the announcement, and was Bishop Musa and Bishop Thomas leading this convention, international convention, but because of the instability in Egypt, it was canceled. And then God arranged that the first convention will be held here in the Southern Diocese. And I'm very happy to have the honor and privilege to host all of you in the first One Cup convention. I'm very happy to see youth from 25 states, from America and Canada, and to see fathers, Abuna Peter, Abuna Paul, Abuna John Paul, Abuna Angelus, and Abuna Ruiz from Orlando here. I don't know if any other priests are missing, but Abuna Mina, because I didn't see him. these are also a good thing to be together. I know there's a lecture now, but let me just give you few words about the word arise, the theme of the convention. Arise implies what? Implies you need to do something in any direction. Many times we feel like we are in the middle and we have different roads in front of us. And we don't know which road we choose, which direction we should go. And sometimes this process takes forever to decide which road you will follow. And many of us, we lose motivation, become disinterested and discouraged, so we stay where we are. And actually, Christianity revolves about resurrection. And resurrection actually from the word arise, let's rise. And the first word in the midnight prayers is, arise children of light to praise the Lord of hosts. Arise implies you need actually to take a decision, to make an action. To be successful in your life, there is two elements, a divine element and a human element. The divine element is whatever you cannot do. And the human element is whatever you can do. God will never do your job. Otherwise, God will teach us to be lazy. So whatever you can do, you need to do it. Then actually God will do his part, which you cannot do. Like when the Lord said to the man, arise, take up your bed and walk. God wants him to do that effort. This he can do, to try to get up and then to carry his bed. But what he cannot do is to be healed, and Christ will grant this. Christ wants you to offer the 5 loaves and 2 fish. That's what you can do. But what you cannot do is to feed the multitude from the 5 loaves and 2 fish. That's what Christ will do. That's the divine part. God wants you to remove the stone from the door of the tomb. That's what you can do. Then Christ will raise the dead person, Lazarus, from the death. This is what you cannot do. God wants you to step outside the boat. That's what you can do. And then he will make you walk on the water. That's what you cannot do. God wants you to offer the flour and oil that you have as a widow and set aside that it was Elijah. That's what you can do. And then God will bless the flour and oil to the end of the family. That's what you cannot do. And I can give you examples more and more and more and more. But to be successful in your life, you need to know what you need to do and then to start doing it. Trusting that God will do whatever you cannot do. But start doing your part. Many times we question, but how can I know what's my part? Actually, start by doing what you know already what's your part. For example, God expecting from the spiritual life, God expecting you to praise Him. God expecting you to worship Him. God expecting you to study the scripture and live by it. God expecting you to have fellowship with the assembly of the believers. Start doing these things. Then actually, to have the fruit of the Spirit in your life and to grow your spiritual life and to reach spiritual maturity, this will be the work of the Holy Spirit in you. That's the work of grace. And here actually we can see how grace and works, you know, work in harmony together. Work is what I can do, and grace is what I cannot do. What if I made a wrong choice? What if I make a wrong decision? If you did this to the best of your ability, God will correct it. Because God knows we are fallible. You know, St. Paul, he started to persecute the Christian. And he was thinking this was the right thing. He was pleasing God in his mind by persecuting the Christian. So he chose the wrong route. But as St. Paul said to his disciple Timothy, but God had mercy on me because I have done this in ignorance. So because he did this in ignorance, God had mercy on him and corrected his way in a miraculous way when he appeared to him and told him, why do you persecute me? Until when you will kick against goals? So do your part. Ask God, pray, take counseling, ask others. Then, once your mind is clear about what you need to do, start doing it. And when you do it, don't have double-mindedness. Don't be double-minded. Don't have a second thought. Trust in the Lord and continue in your journey. And if you did your best, but at the end you made a wrong decision, don't worry about it. God will correct it for you. As long as you prayed, you asked counseling, and you studied very well the pros and cons, and you are following the commandment of God, don't worry. Even if you make a wrong choice, God will correct it for you. He promised us that He will be with us all the days until the second coming. When actually you started doing it, you need actually to have a support system. And we have two support systems, invisible and visible. The invisible is a cloud of witnesses surrounding us, praying for us, supporting us, encouraging us. And the visible is the church, the assembly of believers, your brothers and sisters in the Church of Christ. So this will keep you motivated. I will finish my word by saying, they classify the people into six stages in order to end up achieving your goal. The first stage is the stage of the non-motivated person who is apathetic, who decides to do nothing. The second stage is the stage of a dreamer. Now, he at least has a dream, about what he needs to do. The third stage is the stage of the willful person who has a will to do something. Fourth stage is the stage of the acting person who moves just from having a will but to act. And the fifth stage is the perseverance. He is persevering to finish and to accomplish what he started. And the last stage is the stage of victory or achievement. You achieved your goal. So maybe in during this retreat, try to examine yourself and to see where are you. Maybe in your spiritual life you are in the third stage. Maybe in your academic life you are in the fourth stage, fifth stage. Maybe in the social life you are in the sixth stage, whatever. So it is not for every aspect in your life. So try to see every aspect in your life and see where are you. Are you in the first, second, third? Again, let me remind you. First stage, non-motivated, apathetic. He doesn't want to do anything. Second stage, dreamer. He's dreaming. Third stage, willing. Now he has the will. He started to do some plans. Fourth stage, acting. He started to make the will to convert it into real action. Fifth stage, persevering. Because sometimes when we start, you know, there is a tendency to relapse, go back and forth. So you need to persevere. And the sixth stage, you need, that's the achievement through the grace of God. May the Lord actually bless all of you. And again, I'm very happy to see all of you convene together here in spirit of oneness, unity, and love. May the Lord bless this convention to grow in His love and in His knowledge and to achieve spiritual maturity in our life. Glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.